Basic concepts of human anatomy part 1. In this video you are going to see some basic terms used in human anatomy. Before knowing the actual subject of human anatomy, everyone must know some basic concepts. Firstly, what is human anatomy? Human anatomy is the science which deals with structure of human body. Actual formation of human body is studied under this subject. Anatomy forms firm foundation of whole art of medicine and introduces the student to greater part of medical terminology. Next, we are going to see different positions of body. First one is anatomical position. When a person is standing straight with looking forwards, both arms by side of body, palms facing forwards, both feet together, the position is anatomical position. In image, we can clearly see the position. Second position is supine position. When a person is lying on the back, arms by side of body, palms facing upwards and feet put together, the position is supine position. In image, we can clearly see the position. Next position is prone position. Person is lying on face, chest and abdomen. It is said to be in prone position. In image, we can clearly see the position. Next topic is planes. Our body is divided into different planes. First plane is median plane or mid-sagittal plane. What is median plane? A plane passing through center of body, dividing the body into two equal halves, that is right half and left half. It is called as median plane, or also called as mid-sagittal plane. Second one is sagittal plane. Plane parallel to median or mid-sagittal plane, it is called as sagittal plane. Next one is coronal plane. A plane at right angles to sagittal or median plane, which divides the body into anterior and posterior half, is called as coronal plane. Next and last plane is transverse plane. A plane at right angles to both sagittal as well as coronal plane, which divides the body into upper and lower parts, it is called as transverse plane. In image, we can clearly see sagittal plane, coronal plane and transverse plane. Now we will see some terms used in relation to trunk. First one is ventral, also called as anterior. It means it is front of trunk. Dorsal or posterior, it means it is the back of trunk. Next one is medial. It is a plane close to the median plane, that is towards the center of body. Second one is lateral. It is opposite of medial. It means a plane away from the median plane, that is away from the center of body. Next one is proximal, also called as cranial as well as superior. It is close to the head end of trunk, while distal, also called as caudal or inferior, it is close to the lower end of trunk. Superficial, it is close to skin or towards the surface of body. Deep means away from the skin or away from the surface of body. Ipsilateral, it means on the same side of body. Contralateral, it means on the opposite side of body. Next topic we are going to see is movements at different parts of body. First one is movements at upper limb. First movement is flexion. When two flexure surfaces are brought close to each other, it is called as flexion. Example is, in elbow joint, when front of arm and forearm are opposed to each other, it is called as flexion of elbow joint. Next movement is extension. It is opposite of flexion when extensor or dorsal surfaces are brought in as much as approximation. Example is straighten the arm and forearm at elbow joint, which is called as elbow extension. Next movement is abduction. When limb is taken away from the body, it is called as abduction. Adduction, when limb is brought close to the body, that means it is opposite of abduction. Next movement is circumduction. It is combination of extension, abduction, flexion and adduction in a sequence. Example is bowling. Next movement is medial rotation. When arm rotates medially, bringing the flexed forearm across the chest, and lateral rotation, when arm rotates laterally, taking the flexed forearm away from the body. Next movement is supination. When palm is facing forwards or upwards, as in putting food in the mouth, it is called as supination. Pronation, opposite of supination, when palm faces backwards or downwards, as in picking food with fingers from the plate. Next movement is adduction of fingers. When fingers are get together, it is called as adduction. Opposite of adduction is abduction of fingers, when fingers are separated. Next one is opposition of thumb. When tip of thumb touches the tips of any other fingers, it is called as opposition of thumb. And last movement is circumduction of thumb. Movement of extension, abduction, flexion and adduction in sequence is called as circumduction of thumb. Next one is movements at lower limb. First one is flexion of thigh. When front of thigh comes in contact with front of abdomen, it is called as flexion of thigh or flexion of hip joint. Opposite of flexion is extension. When person stands erect, it is extension of thigh. Abduction means when thigh is taken away from the median plane, and adduction means when thigh is brought close to the median plane. Medial rotation, when thigh is turned medially, it is called as medial rotation of hip joint. Lateral rotation, when thigh is turned laterally, it is called as lateral rotation of hip joint. Flexion of knee, when back of thigh and back of leg come in opposition, it is called as flexion of knee. Opposite of flexion, extension. When thigh and leg are in a straight line, it is called as extension of knee. Now movements at ankle joint. First one is dorsiflexion. When dorsum of foot is brought close to the front of leg, it is called as dorsiflexion of foot. Opposite of dorsiflexion is plantar flexion. That is when sole of foot or plantar aspect of foot faces backwards, it is called as plantar flexion. Next movement is inversion, which is at subtalar joint. When medial border of foot is raised from the ground, it is called as inversion. While eversion is when lateral border of foot is raised from the ground. Now we will see the movements at neck, that is cervical region. First one is flexion. When face comes closer to chest, it is called as flexion. Extension, when face is brought away from the chest, it is called as extension. Lateral flexion, or also called as side flexion, It is of right side as well as left side. When ear is brought close to the shoulder, it is called as lateral flexion. Next one is rotation, also called as lateral rotation. When neck rotates so that chin goes to opposite side, it is called as rotation. It is also of right side as well as left side. Next one is movements